everyone, welcome back. For those of you who are new here, I'm Dr. Ilavarasi Joseph, and good to have you here. I don't know about everyone, but growing up, there is this one insult that everyone loved to throw around. Do you have a brain? Does your brain even work? Why can't you use your brain? Fast forward, in my many visits as neuroscientist, this one question often comes up. I'm not good in my academic. Does that mean that my brain is not working? Which is not surprising because most of the times we equate good grades as being smart as having good brain. Added to that is the never dying myth that we use only 10% of our brain at any given time. The truth is our brain is working all the time, doing tasks that are extraordinary and doing it very efficiently, so much so that we don't even realize that those tasks are being accomplished while we go about our everyday lives. Take for example our vision. It seems so simple. We just open our eyes and all the beauty and life around us is so easily accessible to us. We believe that we see with our eyes, but the truth is we see with our brains. When you look at the structure of the eye, you see the retina, which is a thin layer of cells that are sensitive to light and trigger the nerve impulse that is carried by the optic nerve to the brain. Anatomically, due to the design of the eye, you can see that there is a region of the retina without any photoreceptors, that is the rod and the cone cells. That is the place where the optic nerve is getting out of the eyeball. Because of that, we have a dark spot in our field of vision, one for each eye, where we are not receiving any input from the eyes. But we are not aware of that blind spot because our brain fills in the gap in our visions based on the information that it has about what our eyes are looking at. You can actually test your blind spots at home with this easy image. Either print out the blind spot test image or pause this video at this image with the plus sign and the circle. Look straight at the image with your nose positioned somewhere between the plus and the circle. With your left eye closed, focus your right eye on the plus sign. Avoid looking at the circle. Now move closer to the image slowly. Don't take your focus off the plus sign while you are doing this. At some point between 10 to 14 inches, the circle will disappear from your peripheral vision and the brain will read the surrounding white color to fill up the empty space. And that spot exactly is your blind spot. As you can see, our brain is very good in filling up the blanks so that we have a complete perception of our world. And that is not the only cool thing that our brain does. What if I tell you that we are all living in the past and our brain makes us believe that our present is absolute? Again, look at this image. The information from the retina needs to travel all the way to the region of the cortex called the occipital lobe, where it is then processed in the primary visual cortex. It takes around 76 to 80 milliseconds for the information to reach from the retina to this part of the brain. You might think that 76 milliseconds is not a big deal. It is not if you are just looking and appreciating an artwork. Think about playing catchball. The person in front of you is throwing the ball at you, and it will take several milliseconds for this information to reach the brain from the eyes. And then again, 120 milliseconds for us to take action based on this information. That is to get ready with your hands to catch the ball. All the while, the ball is in continuous motion, so the information that the brain has on where the ball is always going to lag behind on where exactly the ball is. If this is the case for the simple catch ball, then think about sports where the balls travel at very high speed, like tennis, baseball, and cricket. A ball that is traveling about 60 miles per hour would have moved around 10 feet during this lag time. If we perceive the position of the ball on the basis of the most recent information available, then we would never be able to hit or catch the ball accurately. How does the brain manage not to ruin these sports for us? More importantly, how is the brain so successful in making us live in the present and absolutely unaware of this time lag in our visual perception? Scientists have long hypothesized that our brain handles this situation by simply making calculations based on the trajectory of the object and then predicting where that moving object will be. Recently, using functional neuroimaging studies, scientists for sure have confirmed that the brain indeed uses motion extrapolation to locate moving objects and make up for the lag in the arrival of the real-time information. The experiment showed that the brain sees the moving object based on its prediction where the object will be, instead of based on the real-time information from the eyes, and then make sure to double-check that it is correct when the real information from the eyes reach it. The fun part is what the scientists found when they made the moving object change its direction. The brain, as smart it is, went ahead and extrapolated the position of the object based on its trajectory from the point at which it changed the direction. When it discovered that it was wrong, that is, of course, when the real information from the eyes reached it, it went ahead and quickly overrode its original prediction. What that means is that the brain is a master cover-up artist, saying that the object is here and then saying the object was never here, literally rewriting our experiences. And we all can agree that the brain is very effective in its cover-up from our everyday experiences, as we all feel that our lives are moving seamlessly, both spatially and temporally. That, my friends, is the truly amazing power of the organ brain. It's such a wonderful thing that we all have our own copies of this super powerful computing machine that is always rooting for us. So please take care of it, eat a healthy and balanced diet, sleep well, exercise as best as you can, and spend time laughing a lot with the ones that you love. Till next time, take care.